Rudolph.
It's the most wonderful time of the year as far as Kendall's concerned, because look how she's showing out.
I'm so excited, guys.
I just love the season. It's not even just Christmas. I mean, after Thanksgiving, we are just rolling through the season.
It's cute that you're trying to act like it happens after Thanksgiving.
Right.
When we know that Mariah Carey kicks it off after Halloween. It's also the time of the year where we debate, is Love Actually actually a holiday movie or not?
It actually is.
Does it actually suck?
Does it actually suck?
No.
Okay. Dramatic pause.
Lisa.
Girl, it actually sucks. I'm sorry. I do not love that movie. I think it's overhyped. I think people love it because they think that they're supposed to love it, and you're afraid that you will sound uncool if you say that you do not like it. I'm going to take one for the team and represent all y'all people who know you don't really like Love Actually. Let's be real. 2021 is the year of honesty. Let's be honest.
Let's be honest that we love getting in touch with our feelings. I mean, these are characters that are really going through some things.
I have enough of that in my real life. I don't need to see it in a movie.
But that is the criteria for a good Christmas movie, right? I mean, you have to have Christmas in the background, sure. But then you also have to have some sort of dramatic, you know, emotional, cathartic moment.
What's happening to me?
I'm warming your heart.
That's why Die Hard is actually a Christmas movie.
Welcome to the party, pal!
Woo! People have been debating this since the movie came out, and Bruce Willis even chimed in on this debate.
Die Hard is not a Christmas movie! It's a goddamn Bruce Willis movie.
I mean, Friday After Next is also a Christmas movie.
Yes.
Back in the ghetto. The only place where you can get bribed by Santa Claus on Christmas Eve.
If we're gonna let, you know, Bruce Willis dictate what is and what isn't, I think we have to put that on the table.
Absolutely, it has to be in there. People feel very strongly, clearly, about holiday movies, and I feel like you either really love them or you really can't stand them.
I hate Christmas!
You either live for all the Lifetime, Hallmark, Netflix shenanigans.
It's quantity over quality, people, and we are just blasting your ass with these.
Or you're just like, no, it's too much. Because some of them are so cheesy.
You're my real Christmas present.
That's what the season is about.
I'm mad at you.
I don't think that's fair.
I'm gonna have to throw this one in the cheesy category. You know which one I'm gonna talk about.
You're not talking about the Princess Switch 3, I hope.
Yeah.
Absolutely I am. Vanessa Hudgens plays three separate characters. I love her. This movie is cheesy, but I feel like it's going for cheesy.
It's going for cheesy, and sometimes you want to watch cheesy.
I like cheesy on my pizza. Sometimes my content, not so much.
Where's the cheese?
Do you think Gremlins is a Christmas movie?
Ooh, they did wear the hats though, didn't they? I hadn't thought about that. I feel like we need some type of council, and we can co-chair this if you would like.
I would love to.
Determining what is actually a holiday movie and what is not. I feel like the people need it. We're doing it for you guys.
For you. Well, here's another argument for you.
Let's
and I'm
go.
Here pro claymation movies. I have to have them. I need to see Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
One of my favorites.
Santa Claus is coming to town. There are some, a very small camp of folks who believe it's a little creepy. But I also think it's kind of nostalgic, you know, like that is how we were able to create these movies of the time.
Absolutely. And the classics will always be there for us. It's a Wonderful Life, Miracle on 34th Street. Classics like Home Alone.
Kevin!
Now butt up against things that feel like they're trying to become classics, like Elf.
Christmas is the greatest day in the whole wide world.
And the Polar Express.
Oh, love Polar Express.
This is the Polar Express!
Just think that like years from now, people are gonna be talking about that like they talk about the films that we view as classics. I have to throw in Charlie Brown Christmas there too. I actually own the soundtrack, the music, wonderful. The scene, Schroeder's playing the piano, Linus getting down. I love the Peanuts.
That's what Christmas is all about, Charlie Brown.
Yeah, and you mentioned music, which is another big part to it, but that also reminds me of The Grinch and one of my favorite songs of the season. Where, you know, she's like,
when are you Christmas?
you're just gonna let me go on and on by myself?
Yes, because Kendall clearly wants a record deal. Netflix biggie last year was Jingle Jangle.
No matter who you are, no matter what you do, the magic lives inside of you.
You love it, girl, don't
you? I love it. I love a good musical.
I can always tell when you love something because you do this. Holiday movies are also big for these three name actresses. I'm talking about the Candace Cameron Burrs.
Oh, it's finally Christmas! Okay, well, technically it's still fall.
The Melissa Joan Harts.
It is I, the host of Lifetime Christmas Movies Present.
They feel like they're in everything. I love that Kelly Rowland, formerly of Destiny's Child, she now has a whole franchise of holiday movies.
Sweet.
Tamara Mowry, like all these people that you may not see ordinarily in projects, come holiday season, some of them have multiple films out.
Can you imagine a world without Lifetime Christmas movies?
So I'm sure they're not mad about it because these films are so beloved and they have such a cult following.
Mm-hmm. You know when you're gonna watch them.
We have to make 15,000 cookies before Christmas.
You need some extra joy to get to the end of the year. I mean, especially this whole last 2 years that we've had.
No movies. We're in the movie.
Look, I'm all for escapism. I'm all for wanting to find your joy. I mean, so jingle your bell, girl. Jingle
I will. Your bell. I will jingle the bell. You know, I live in Atlanta, so I probably won't see snow
except
on my screen.
I think it's a great point because it does transport us someplace we can't go.
Hang up your pretty stockings. Turn out the lights. Santa Claus is coming down your chimney today.
For me, I love these holiday films because it takes me back to my childhood when life was simple and I didn't have to pay any bills.
Adults love to say things like that.
Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. And if you want more, head over to cnn.com/poplife. Thanks so much for watching, and if you want to subscribe to my newsletter, head